Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Jury Service. Today we are taking here question number 261 to 280. This is the part 15th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. Those who have not watched the previous video of this series, so I will provide the link of these videos in comment box. And if anybody want to join our WhatsApp group, the link of WhatsApp group is also available in comment box. Now start here question number 261. The personal attendance of accused can be dispensed with option A here 207 of CRPC, option B here 206 of CRPC, option C here 205 of CRPC, and option D here 256 of CRPC. Now come to the point here. First section is here 207. Now section number 207. So section 207 here, the provided that the supply of police report to the accused. So first point here, it is the provision, the police report. So police report provided to accused. What is the purpose of providing the police report to accused? For proper defense of the accused. So everybody having a right to defense before the, in court proceeding. So this is the object here, to accused can defense himself. That's why the police report provided to the accused under section 207. Now here 206, section 206 of CRPC. It is the special summon. So this is special summon. Summon of petty cases. Of petty cases. The small cases, the magistrate issues the special summon. So this section 206 provided the provision of special summon of petty cases. Now next here, next section here 205. This is 205. So 205, the court having the power, the court having a discretion to avoid the personal appearance of accused. This is the answer of our question here. So here court is having a discretionary power, discretion. Who has? Magistrate have discretion to dispense the personal appearance of accused. So personal appearance of accused according to section 205. Now last important section is there 256. This section is provided that the non-appearance of complainant. According to section 256, there is no provision of accused. This is the provision for complainant. He is not appear in court at the time of proceeding. It may be possible he does not want to appearing, or he is dead there. He has died. In that condition, he is unable to present the court. So the court proceeding is stopped. The court give the option to the legal representatives of the complainant to represent. This is the another process. Now come to our question here. So question is here, the personal attendance of accused can be dispensed. So we are cleared here. So personal appearance of accused is dispensed by the magistrate, and he has the discretionary power under section 205. Now question number 262. The error and omissions. This is important here. Error and omission in framing of charge. When the magistrate framing a charge under section 211. So there is a error and omission. So option A here is a material in all circumstances shall vitiate the trial. Option B here, material only if has occasioned failure of justice. This is very important point here. Failure of justice to the accused. And option C here, material and the accused is liable to be acquitted. No, this is not correct here. And option B, option D here, both A and C. So answer of this question is here, option B. Error and omission only material if the occasion the failure of justice to the accused. Otherwise, such error or omission is not having a material in the trial. Now question number 263, the addition and alteration of charge has been provided. According to section 214, according to section 215, 16, 18. So what is the provision of section 215? The 215 provided the effect of error. And this section is read with section 464. And 216 provided that the court may alter the charge. There is not must. Court having the power to alter the charge. At any time the court having the power to alter the charge. According to section 216. And 218 provided here the separation of charge for distinct offense. So here 218, separation of charge. Separation of charge, separate charge. So there is separate charge for distinct offense. Offense. Now come to our question here. So the addition and alteration of charge has been provided in section 216. Now question number 264. Under section 216 of CRPC, the court has power to add to the charge already framed. Option B here, alter the charge already framed. Option C here, only alter, not add to charge and already framed. Option D here, add and altered both things here. The charge both. So option D is correct here. According to section 216, the court may alter or add the charge, both things here. Now question number 265. Under section 217 of CRPC, on addition of alteration of charge, option A, the prosecution has right to recall the witness. So here provision of provided prosecution, recall the witness already examined. Option B here, the accused has right to recall the witness already examined. Option C here, the prosecution has right to recall, to call any further witness. And option D, all of the above. So in first option there is a prosecution, in second there is a defense means accused, in third there is a provision of further witness and which are not examined previously. And option, all these options are correct here. So answer D is here. According to section 217, the addition and alteration of charge, so the prosecution, accused, and having the re-examination of witness who examined. Now question number 266, the joinder of charge is permissible. So joinder of charge is permissible under section 219, under section 220, under section 221, all of the above. So joinder of charge is available in all these sections, 219, 20 and 21. So answer is here, option D, all of the above. Now question number 267, the joint trial of several person, more than one, is permissible under section 219, under section 223, under section 221, under section 222. So here answer is option B, under section, option B, under section 223 of CRPC. So under section 223, It is provided that what person may be charged jointly. So all these persons, they are, the conditions are there. So what persons may be charged jointly. So in this answer is here 223. Now question number 268. Which of the following is incorrect? The two diametrically different version can be put a joint trial. Option B, two versions which not only mutually exclusive cannot be put a joint trial. Option C, here joint trial of several person partly by applying one clause and partly applying another clause under section 223 is authorized. Option D here, the various clause under section 223 of CRPC are not mutually exclusive. So in this question, option is here, answer is here, the which of the following is incorrect? So option A is correct. This is incorrect. The two diametrically different version can be put into a trial, in a trial. So this is not a diametrically differentiate. They are the two versions and not mutually, and these provisions are correct, but this is wrong provision. So answer is here option A. Now question number 269. If an accused charge a major offense, but the fact on the established he cannot be held guilty of that major offense. At the same time, the fact established they indicate that the minor offense has been committed. The person so try for a major offense and can be convicted for a such major offense. It has been so provided. So this is very good question here. The accused is try for a major offense, but during the trial, the magistrate having find there, he has committing a minor offense. So what is the provision of this related to this matter is now option A here under section 220, option B here 223, option C here 222, and option D here 221. So here answer is option C according to section 222. So 222 is provided that when a different offenses, the different, the proved can be concluded in offense charged. So according to section 222 when the offense proved, so in this question the proved is minor offense and included in different offense charged. So here when the offense proved and included in the offense charged, so answer is here option 222 of CRPC. So last line of this question is here, a person so try for a major offense can be convicted for a such minor offense, it has been proved. So the person who is charged with a major offense and can also be convicted for minor offense if the court find that the minor offense he is also committed. So the so such person is convicted for these offense, minor as well as major. Now question number 270. The forms in which the charge may be framed are set forth in option A 211 of CRPC, option B 214 of CRPC, first schedule of CRPC, second schedule of CRPC. It is clear here, their question is here, form. The form of charge may be framed as set forth under second schedule of CRPC. The first schedule provided that the offense is bailable, non-bailable, and which magistrate takes, and the punishment. These things are provided. But in second schedule, there are the various forms. So one of the form is charge form. And here, section 211 provided that the content of charge, in which things is included in charge. So 211 provided the content of charge. 214 provided that the word used in the charge. So there should be a using the legal word by the magistrate during framing of charge. So which word is using during the charge, the sense of law, such words must having the sense of law, not other words are using. So for 214 provided this thing. First schedule I already express here. So second schedule provided the form of charges. Now question number 271. If once the accused of an act may be amount of theft and receiving a stolen property and a cheating, and each charge of theft only, and from the evidence of it appear that he has committing a cheating, and he can be convicted for cheating, although no charge for cheating has been formally framed by virtue of section 214, option A here, option B 221, option C 223, and option D here 224. So in this question, answer is here option B 221. If there is a doubt, so 221 is provided that the provision, the magistrate having a doubtful condition. So what offense? Offense has been committed. So he charged all these circumstances and written in the charge, and the conditions of all these offense related should be written in the charge. So 221 is there. 221. Now question number 272. The due to non-framing of charge, there is non-framing of charge, or due to any error, omission, and irregularity. These three words are very important. Any error, omission, and irregularity in the charge, finding sentence or any other by a court of competent jurisdiction. So option A here shall be invalid always, shall be valid generally. Option C here shall be invalid only when the fact it has the occasion, this is very important word, failure of justice. Option D, both B and C. So in this question, answer is here option D, both B and C, means shall be valid generally if there is error, omission, or irregularity, and not procured, not generate the failure of justice. So shall be valid generally, but if they are content, if they are produced the failure of justice, so shall be invalid. So, and if the non-framing of charge causes the error, omission, or irregularity, may be generally invalid, but in some time, at the time of failure of justice, it is invalid. So option D is correct. Now question number 273. Under section 267, the production warrant in respect of a person detained in prison can be issued for a purpose of investigation, inquiry, trial, all of the above. So answer is here option D, all of the above, because these two words are there, investigation according to section 267. These two words, now I write, explain here, trying to hear, according to section 267, they are using the power having the magistrate first here requiring the attendance of prison for, and the criminal causes and the first here inquiry for inquiry purpose, and second one here trial, and investigation is not there, but they use the third point here, they use the other proceeding. Other proceeding, that's why I choose all of the above, because these two points are there, inquiry and trial, and the third point investigation not there, but other proceeding is there, that's why all of the above here answer. Now question number 274, in criminal trial the evidence on affidavit can be given for allegation made in respect of public servant, option B here, for any person whose evidence is of a formal character, option C here both A and B, and option D here neither A nor B. So answer is here option B, both A and B. So option here, the allegation made in respect of public servant, and now B here, for any person whose evidence is of formal character, that's why both options are correct here. Now question number 275, the criminal trial, the admission denial of document can be done by the prosecution or the accused. So here admission is denial. Now option A here 294 of CRPC, option B here Section 293 of CRPC, option C here Section 295 of CRPC, Section D 296 of CRPC. So 293, provided that the report of expert, this is very important here. So 293, provide the report, whose report? Expert report. The expert provision is under Section 45 of Evidence Act. So those expert persons which are mentioned in Section 45 of Evidence Act, their report is submitted according to Section 293. Now come to Section 294. So 294, for no formal proof of certain document. So it is no formal proof of formal, no formal proof of certain document. So this section here, and now section 295 and 296. So according to our question here, the criminal trial, the admission denial, the document can be done by the prosecution of accused. So here answer is option A, because I already expressed here the no formal proof of certain document. So the certain documents, no formal proof there, that's why answer is here option A, according to 294, and 293 provided the provision of report of expert. Now question number 276, the report of certain government scientific expert are admissible in evidence without any formal proof. So answer is here option A, 291 provided that disposition of medical witness. So medical report, we are generally in practical life, the examination of the dead bodies or the examination of accused, medical examination of accused. So the medical practitioner giving the medical report. So this section is provided that the medical report. Medical report. and section 292 provided that the evidence of officer of mint who was printing the currency notes or coins, so the evidence of the officer of mint, so according to section 292 and 293, I already expressed that the report of expert, and this is our answer of this question here, because they are scientific expert of government. So of section 293, I already again express here, 291 provide the medical report, and 292 the report of officer of mint, and 293 the report of scientific expert, and 294 no formal proof of certain document. In the previous question's answer here, no report of certain documents according to 294. Now question number 277. Just problem ho raha hai. Now question number 277. The examination of witness in the absence of accused can be done under section 299 of CRPC, 321 of CRPC, 224 of CRPC, 301 of CRPC. So in this question, answer is here option A, 299. The examination of witness in the absence of accused, this is the exceptional case, the examination of witness in the absence of accused according to section 299. Now question number 278, the rule autere fois acquit and autere fois the commit commit is contained in section 200 321 320 300 and 298. It is very famous maxim, and the answer is here option C. And this section, once the accused is committed, so autere fois means once the accused is committed or acquittal, not to be tried for same offense, and same thing is provided in article 220 subsection, sorry, clause 2, article 20 clause 2 of Indian Constitution provided the same thing. There is little difference, but here these things, it means no person convicted or acquittal not to be tried for same offense. Now question, doctrine of double jeopardy is also called it. Now question number 279, during inquiry or trial the accused is remanded to custody, option A section 167 subsection 1, option B 167 subsection 2, option C section 309 subsection 1, and option D here 309 subsection 2. So in this question, answer is here option D, section 309 subsection 2. So in this question there is a remand, so remand is section according to 167. Such remand is, there are the 15 days remand in according to section 167, but and in police remand, but this remand according to section 167 is before a trial, before a cognizance, before the cognizance of magistrate during the investigation process. But according to section 309 subsection 2, such remand is after the taking cognizance. This is the main difference between these two remand, and both remand having maximum time is 15 days. Now which thing is actually according to bookish knowledge, the magistrate may warrant the remand. So first here provision here may, according to section 309 subsection 2, magistrate may by warrant. So first second point here, warrant, magistrate issues the warrant, the remand the accused if and where is accused in custody, custody. This wrong word here, right again. CUSTODY, custody. Now question number 280, final question of this video. During inquiry or trial, under section 309 of CRPC, the magistrate can remand the accused for maximum 1 month at the time, for maximum 15 days at the time, for maximum period of 14 days at the time, for period till next date respective of days. So it is clear here, option B is correct here, maximum 15 days. According to section 167, the magistrate grant the 15 days police remand and after that judicial custody of 60 days or 90 days. 90 days custody in the offense related to the capital punishment, life imprisonment or offense are related to more than 10 years of imprisonment, and remaining offense is related to the 60 days judicial custody, and police remand is here 15 days, and the same 167 here 15 days. So answer of this question is here option B, maximum 15 days according to section 309. In this video there are some problem in setting off the film, but I am trying to our best. Thank you for watching this video, and if you like this video please click on like button. Thank you.